too small, too ugly. That one's too smart. Where are all the good pets these days? I'd hate to have to pluck one off the street. They never seem to last. Little one, what do we have here? Step closer to the light. I'm not going to hurt you. Oh, my, my. I didn't think this second-rate menagerie would have a pseudo-dragon of all things. Then again, any scrupulous market for magical creatures wouldn't dream of dealing with something like you. Oh, no, they wouldn't. No, they wouldn't. You little camera stellata felony. Trafficking you carries a 40-year prison sentence. Yes, you do. Oh, good little dragon. Who likes neck scratches? Oh, too easy. A friendly face, a gentle hand, and we're already fast friends. But don't be embarrassed. You shouldn't be in this dungeon, little pet. No room to fly. Not enough food to eat. You are a mistreated little thing, aren't you? You need a nice warm bath. And to be wrapped up in hot towel. And fed little treats, and don't you, my pet? Do you know who I am? I'm the Lady Gingerwood. You might have read about my wedding in the newspapers, or about my poor late husband's sudden illness and demise, leaving me all alone in the mansion with nothing but servants to keep me company. I think I need a pet. Not a cat. I want something useful. And not a dog fetching sticks, scaring burglars. Thieves do not trespass against me, and if I need something fetched, well, it's going to be a little more valuable than a stick. Have you figured it out, little one? There's more dungeons under London than this one. And you, my new friend, have a very narrow frame. There are doors, drains, crawl spaces, and ancient vents that I cannot navigate. But you might. I can think of a certain druid circle underneath Hyde Park. And if there were some gemstones I wanted retrieved, well, why would I hire a thief when I can buy one? Especially one as cute and silent as you. How's that, my toy dragon? Do you want to be a good little pet and do mistress's bidding? Ah, you're just a submissive little thing, aren't you? You would do exactly what I say for belly rubs and to hear my sweet voice praising you. I wonder how much you remember your life before the curse. Think that you were heir to your own estate before you were polymorphed into this. Yes. I know all about you. Perhaps more than you do. There is a great game in this city. Land, magic, money, power. All tangled up. Country estates give parliamentary seats, generous donations by access to the mystic tomes of Oxford. Tried to hold on to your little inheritance without also mastering spellcraft well. It looks like power has a way of finding more worthy hands. But why waste a human life when you can find new purpose as someone's magic tool? Which is, of course, exactly what happens when the players of the great game knock a pawn off the chessboard. Oh, don't you worry your pretty little head about it. There's no need to fret. Mistress is here to do all the thinking for you. Just because you can no longer comprehend your heart's desire doesn't mean it's out of reach. Revenge. Such a sweet word. Do you remember revenge? That nagging feeling that soon these trappers will need new magic animals to stock their cells, more kidnapping, more deprivations, and nothing will have changed. Would you like revenge? If that makes you purr, then let's see if you can remember another word. Restoration. No polymorph has ever been undone yet. But there's never been a sorceress like me before either. It would just require a little careful research and miracles become possible. Oh, sweet little thing. You were never made for this world, this game. But I was. And I will protect you, and pamper you, and love you. Because I learned my lesson the first time. If you want to love someone, make sure you own them. Now I want you to listen carefully. There is a very small cage I can put you in to get you back to the Gingerwood estate. But I think life has been cruel enough to you already. I think it would be much more pleasant if I carried you out of here in my arms. I'll pay the nice menagerie keeper for you, and you'll stay nice and docile, and not try to claw his eyes out. And then we can walk out into the streets of London, and my friends will say, Lady Gingerwood, what a sweet little dragon you've got. It's as gentle as a doe. And you'll let them pet you and rub your belly. And then I'll take you to the butcher shop and I'll buy you some sweet bread for you to snack on during our carriage ride home. Then I'll catch up on my reading and you can lay on my fur coat while the carriage rocks you to sleep. When we arrive, you'll follow at my heels 3 steps behind. My toes get cold at night. And I would so love to have you at the foot of my bed, my little pet. Now, doesn't that sound so much nicer than a little cage? It's not a trick question. I'm very content to spoil you rotten, so long as you make yourself completely pliable to my will. Now, you've done a very good job paying attention. I know how hard it is for you to hold on to complex ideas these days, but there's really only one thing that matters. Just nod or shake your head. Do you know who owns you? Good. Now come to your owner. Oh, that's right, precious. Who wants cuddles from mistress? Oh, yes you do. Yes you do, my new friend. Oh, I'm so glad we understand each other so well. Oh, no need to be alarmed. This one is quite tame in the right hands. They just crave a little structure. How much for this one? So little, after all your trouble. I'm sure keeping a cell in such a disgusting state must be hard work. And you feed them? You did feed them, didn't you? Once a week, perhaps? That must keep you working around the clock. Such a diligent menagerie keeper you are. Huh? See? Totally docile. You can pet them if you like, if you're brave enough. I didn't think so. Payment? Of course. Pet, remember when I told you not to harm your nice menagerie keeper? You did such a good job restraining yourself, but I've changed my mind.